Hello, I'm Christina.
I'm Emax, and you are watching the Crypto Experts Show.
We have been talking recently about mining and block rewards.
Today, we'll dig deeper into a subject. We'll find out if it's worthwhile being an individual miner.
We already know that mining is about solving complex cryptography-based problems. That is how the transactions are verified and new data blocks are added.
Hashes is the name for the calculations required to find these solutions. So, the capacity of the machines used for mining is measured in hashes per second.
When Bitcoin was first introduced, a simple PC was enough to find the solution and earn a block reward.
But these times are long gone. Cryptocurrencies attract many new users, and now mining is more competitive.
So the natural solution was to upgrade the mining equipment to achieve more hash power.
Exactly, from CPU processors to FPGA matrices, then to GPU graphic processors, and finally to the standard ASIC mining machines of today.
These are expensive, specialized machines with high capacity. Currently, this is around 100 terahashes per second, and they consume enormous amounts of electricity.
True.
These cryptographic algorithms are very complex and difficult to solve. The more ASICs, the better your chances of getting the reward. You also need some technology and logistics to keep them running round the clock.
But this sounds like a hard thing for a single miner.
So, if not mining on your own, what then?
A pool. But don't confuse it with a swimming pool. I mean a mining pool. Joint resources.
But we will talk more about it in the next episode.
See you.
See you.